Magandang umaga kapamilya. This Simbang Gabi Mass, we would like to offer in a very special way for those who are affected by the recent typhoon, Typhoon Odette. May they know that they are not alone, and may we all come together in prayer and in works of support and love so that we may help our brothers and sisters recover and prepare for the Feast of Christmas.
Magandang umaga, kapamilya. Welcome to the fourth day of our Kapamilya Simbang Gabi. This Mass is specially offered for all teachers. Let us pray together the Oratio Imperata.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to strengthen our faith and hope. We pray for all health workers, protect and sustain them. For those who passed on, reward them with eternal life and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe and guide them, most especially our leaders. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who died in agony and loneliness. Be their consolation. Embrace them and their families with your love. We pray for families who suffer due to loss of jobs and income, and for all who experience anxiety and fear, may they know they are not alone. Inspire us all to come together in fraternal love, for and service to one another. Guide our experts, instruments in your healing hands, to continue to develop effective vaccines and cures for this virus. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please welcome our Mass celebrant, Father Tito Caluwag, ABS-CBN chaplain.
Father, as our Advent pilgrimage draws to a close, we relight the candles of hope, peace, and joy. And we light the candle of love. Grant us the courage to share your love, love for life and creation, love for sinners and saints, love for the poor and the little ones. We thank you for the hope your Son gives us, for the peace He bestows, for the joy your Spirit pours into our hearts, and for the love that redeems us and shows us the way.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. The prophet Micah prophesies the birth of a shepherd king in Bethlehem, the birthplace of King David. This prophecy will direct the Magi from the east to Bethlehem, where they will worship the child Jesus.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Thus says the Lord, you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Therefore the Lord will give them up until the time when she who is to give birth has born, and the rest of his kindred shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm and shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God. And they shall remain, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
O Shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon the cherubim, shine forth. Rouse your power and come to save us.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted, the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
May your help be with the man of your right hand, with the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved. Far greater than the offerings and sacrifices of the Old Covenant is the obedience of Christ, who came into the world in total submission to God's plan of salvation.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, when Christ came into the world, he said, sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me in holocaust and in sin offerings, you took no delight. Then I said, as is written of me in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O Lord. First he says, sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings, you neither desired nor delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, behold, I come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we have, of course, the famous visitation, no? Which is one of the mysteries of the Rosary. And here again, I think it gives us again very important tips, if you wish, no? In terms of how do we see clearly. And here I think the very central theme of seeing clearly was the presence of Christ. If you notice, the reactions in the narrative were all reactions to the presence of Christ. No? And siguro yun yung unang puntong nais kong imungkahin na pagnilaya natin ngayong ating pang-apat na umaga ng ating simbang gabi, ay pagnilayan natin yung kahalagahan ng presensya ng Diyos sa ating mga buhay at sa ating mga ginagawa at sa ating panalangin. Eh, mahalaga yon kasi kung tunay natin dapat makita ang dapat nating gawin at ang dapat nating piliin kung anong tawag ng Diyos sa atin, ang presensya ng Panginoon ay mahalaga. Nakita nyo yung reaksyon ni Elizabeth, yung reaksyon ni San Juan Bautista, no? So I think that first point is, again, something that I invite you to continue to pray over and to reflect on, especially as we get to Christmas, no? That the presence of Christ, God with us, is one of the most important graces of seeing things clearly. The second point that I invite you to reflect, and people always ask me about this, paano mo malalaman kung yung pinili mo ay tama at yun ang talagang kagustuhan ng Diyos? Lagi ko sinasabi, I think the time that you know you made the right choice is there is peace in your heart, and I think there is joy. And you see that here again in the Gospel, no? In the narrative, that Mary was filled with joy and Elizabeth was filled with joy, and even the baby, John the Baptist, in the womb of Elizabeth was filled with joy. I think peace and joy are always, no? Assurances that we made the right choice because that assures us of the presence of God. Siguro yun yung pangalawang punto, na ang karanasan ng kapayapaan at kagalakan ang siyang nagpapatunay na tama ang ating pinili dahil nandun ang presensya ng Diyos. And then the third and last point is that, you know, you realize that this visitation gospel came after the Annunciation, when Mary committed herself to be the mother of the Savior. Tomorrow, that will be our gospel tomorrow, no? And I think this is the fruit of seeing clearly, choosing well, that all of this now leads us to the action of service. And Mary, most certainly, when she found out that Elizabeth was pregnant, she went to her, she visited her in order to spend time with her and to care for her. And that is the third and final point. All our choices, lahat ng ating pagpili, ay dapat nagbubunga sa pagkalinga at sa ating pagtulong sa ating kapwa. Today, let us pray for this again. Let us pray that through the example of our Blessed Mother and the example of Elizabeth, we may be able to really see clearly what God's will is for us, choose well, and act right. An action that bears fruit in love and service for God and others. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And together now, let us profess our faith.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For as man and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us ask the Father to give us a welcoming heart, ready to prepare the way of our Savior Jesus Christ, who alone can give us the fullness of joy and peace. With confidence we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Like Mary, who brought joy to her cousin Elizabeth, may the Church, the people of God, be bearers of glad tidings to the hopeless, the lonely, the sick, the suffering, and the victims of all forms of injustices. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our government leaders be sensitive to the needs of the people they promise to serve, and be promoters of justice, peace, and love. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all of us respect and defend the rights of the unborn, be sensitive to the situation of pregnant women, and provide better opportunities for the youth. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all families in the world possess a spirit of unity amidst the crisis brought about by the pandemic. May they be more supportive, understanding, and forgiving to each other. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our departed brothers and sisters be cradled by the love and joy that is brought about by God's eternal presence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our dedicated teachers, whose love for their vocation has grown even stronger despite the many challenges they endured, be blessed with life full of joy, with wisdom to guide them even more so they may continue to be bearers of hope for their students. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that are affected by the Typhoon Odette, may we come to their aid and they may experience God's care and compassion through our presence, support, and help. May they know that they are not alone. May we continue to help them as we all prepare for the Feast of our Lord's Nativity. For this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And again, let us continue to pray all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Father, heed the prayer of your people, strengthen our weak knees and fickle hearts, that we may receive you with joy and renewed strength. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as He filled with His power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast days of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Prayer for the Synod. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, thank you po for joining us. And today, on this Sunday, Simbang Gabi, I'd like to thank Rustan's Flower Shop, who did all our decorations, actually has been with us during this past 4 days and will continue to be with us for this Simbang Gabi. We'd also like to thank our choir, the ABS-CBN Choir, Oyayi Choir. And of course, I'd like to thank our chapel volunteers, of course, our crew, our entire crew of ABS to bring the Simbang Gabi Masses from the chapel of ABS. So thank you very much, and we'll continue to see you in the coming days. Thank you.
Dahil sa alay kapwa ng Caritas Pilipinas, alam ba ninyong mahigit ng 1 milyong mga Pilipino ang natutulungan natin? Tunay ngang buhay na buhay, lalo na ngayong pandemya, ang pagmamalasakit, pagbabahagi, at pag-aalay kapwa. Maraming salamat sa inyong patuloy na pagtulong. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year!